The first assembly we're going to work on here is what we call the banjo assembly. It's a bulkhead aft and a vertical tail post. We'll need that assembled first before we proceed with the fuselage construction. That consists, of course, of the vertical spar, the bulkhead aft. There are two rudder hinges and their doublers here, and a control hinge that has the big hole for the rudder control assembly. There are two spar doublers that go in first. We'll show you how they go together here quick. They go in place. The control hinge would be, of course, here at the bottom with the doubler. The lower rudder hinge, and then the top rudder hinge will get assembled. And all this gets riveted to bulkhead F as such. And then this assembly will be our first bulkhead that we'll assemble when we start with the E to F skin. This is the assembly portion of the vertical tail post in bulkhead F, the Hummel H5. We're working off of sheet 12 in your plans. We talked earlier about the components that you're going to need, primarily, of course, bulkhead F, the vertical spar, which we've got Clico together in a sub-assembly here. There's two doublers. The first 025 doubler lays on the inside of the spar. The other 016th extrusion, that's made from a 1/16 by 3/4 extrude aluminum angle, lays inside of that. And then we'll have the lower rudder guide will go down here at the bottom hinge point. That's the rudder control hinge. And then there's two rudder hinges that'll go on in the assembly as well. So we'll go over this real quick. I've got one side kind of Clico together to hold it in place. We'll get the other side started here so things don't move around too much. And you can see on the back side, I've already got the doublers Clicoed in place, the hinge doublers. There's three of those, two for the upper and lower rudder hinge, and then the lower control hinge as well. And the nut plates, these can be bolted with nuts if you want to. We like the idea of having it removable. If the rudder control hinge would wear out or something would wear out, you could just pull it off and replace it with the nut plates. Of course, those get bolted on later, so we'll leave those set aside. The nut plates get Clicoed in on the back side through everything. Hold that in place. And you'll notice on your plans it'll show that these holes for the 3/32 rivets to hold the nut plates are countersunk. That means there's a recessed countersink, so the rivet will lay flush. So when the control hinge gets bolted on, there's no rivet head protruding there. So we'll go ahead and click all this next. Once you get everything Clico together and you think you're ready to rivet, just step back and look at it a little bit. Make sure you got all the parts pre-assembled. I wanted to go over the riveting a little bit with you. We're not going to get into the detail of how to rivet this or that rivet, but just the types of rivets and where to use them. You'll see on our plans that we show a type 1, a type 2, and a type 3 rivet. The type 1 rivet is a solid AN rivet for basically solid riveting. The type 2 rivet is a standard AVEX rivet that we use. And 95% of the rivets in the H5 are these AVEX type rivets. A type 3 rivet is actually an aluminum stem, aluminum rivet. There are very few, if any, left in the H5. There is some confusion over which was a type 2 and 3, so we pretty much eliminated all the type 3 rivets. When it comes to things like nut plates, they take a 3/32 rivet. We don't call them out as a type, they're just in your hardware package as a type. A rivet, it's a BSC 32 or 34. 32 and 34 is the first number designates 3/32, number 3 is 3/32, and 2 is the length. It's 2/8 of an inch or 1/4 inch. And just be sure that when you rivet these, that here where you're going through all the material, it's going to take a 34 rivet. You can see when I put this in there into the hole, the rivet protrudes just about the right amount, and that'll make a good rivet. If I get the wrong rivet in there, I'll show you what a wrong rivet looks like so that you can identify that before you pull it. You can see it's flush. There's not enough rivet head sticking through there. So here where there's a lot of material stack up with this 1/16 doubler, it's going to take the long rivet. And then the short rivets, of course, can be used up on the nut plates at the top where there's no doublers. It's just the small two-inch doubler and the nut plate. Beyond that, when you go to assemble, you'll see the notes on your plans. It's always easier to, you can see it's going to be difficult. These are pull rivets. These are type 2 rivets. So these are just the standard Avex rivets through here on the flange, not going through the bulkhead. But inside of bulkhead F, in this area here, you can go ahead and we'll pop this back off of the, so we can get in here easier to pull these rivets on the sides. Then clicking the bulkhead back on. Of course, you got to make sure you get your everything in place for your doubler and the nut plates. And then you can go ahead and install, we call for the solid type 2 rivets all the way down inside the bulkhead. So what we're doing is we're making sure that we have a good solid connection between bulkhead F and the vertical spar. So it's solid rivets from the fuselage line down on the inside, and then everything else on the sides and through here will all be the standard Avex pull type rivet. There's no holes in the sides of here yet, because when you get your skin wrapped on, the holes will already be in the skin. You'll clamp it in place and just use those as your pilot holes to drill through and attach the vertical fin. So we'll take this back apart, we'll get it kind of pre-assembled, and we'll show you what the finished product looks like.